I'm going to show you how to populate information from one sheet to the other sheets automatically using a VBA. Now, in my little consulting business, I record the work order number, the customer number, the description, the consultant who worked on it, the hours, and the rate, and the total. So that would be in my first sheet that I care about. The second thing would be the work order number, customer number, and the total, so I can keep track of who's paid me or not. And the third sheet I would have is I would basically just have the consultant that's working on the project and the work order number, so just so that you don't have a consultant working on too many projects at the same time. So let's go back to our first sheet, and let's go to our developer tab, and let's start. So let's start a new module here. So let's go sub, and I'm going to call this populate. So then the first thing that we need to do is declare our values. So I'm going to call the first value last row as long, and then I'm gonna declare my end row as long as well. And so the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna define what the last row is. So the last row is the last row that I've entered in my first sheet. So let's go last row. Equals sheet one dot cells rows count one, and we're going down to the bottom, and then we're coming up to the last row here. Okay, so that's defined our last row. And now what we're going to do is we're going to move to the second sheet. And if you remember there, we want to have our information so we see if we're paid. So we're going to do an end row. So we don't want the last row. We want the first blank row is what we want here. And so we're going to go erow equals sheet two, because that's where we are now, dot cells. And then I'm going to go at the beginning, so 1-1, and then I'm going to go current region dot rows dot count, and I'm going to go plus 1. Okay, so that's found our end row on our second sheet. Now let's tell the system what we'd like to copy to the second sheet. So the first cell of the second sheet, we would like the work order number. So let's go sheet two cells, and then we're gonna define it as the end row. End row and the first column. Okay, and then we're going to go is equal to, and then we're going to go sheet one, the place that we're taking this information from is the last row the first cell. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to copy this two more times. Okay, and one more time. We want to do the second column now, and we'd like to bring over the second column from the first sheet as well. And now we want the third column on the second sheet. And we would like to bring over the seventh column from the first sheet. Okay, so that's got the second sheet complete now. So now let's move to the third sheet. And so let's copy this from the top here for end row for the second sheet. And let's put it down here. And let's change this to the third sheet, because this is where we want to keep track of what our consultants are doing, right? So what we're going to do is we are going to go, and I will do the same thing as I'll do some more copying here. Saves me typing. So we're going to go sheet 3. And we want the end row, and we want the first column, and it to say sheet 1, cells, last row, column 4. And then we're going to copy this again. And we would like the second column of the first sheet to be from the last row of the first sheet in the first column. So we'd like to have the consultant and the work order number. Because I'm not a wonderful typist, I'm going to debug this and compile it to see if I have any typing errors. Okay, so now let's run this. Okay, so here we have our information on the first sheet. And there we have our information on the second sheet. And there we have our information on the third sheet. So that's how you auto-populate from one sheet to the other using VBA. Please subscribe.